Thank you, Jim.
We are joined now by ABC Chief Investigative Correspondent Aaron Katursky, who helped break this story tonight. So, Aaron, what do we see next? We're getting more information about this indictment tomorrow. And do you anticipate there may be more people indicted?
Well, that's the number one question, because if the mayor is alone in this, and we don't fully know until it's unsealed whether there are co-defendants here or maybe down the road, we know, as you heard Jim say, all of these individuals in the top echelon of the administration have come under the arms of this investigation. They've insisted they're not targets, but when we asked the U.S. Attorney Damian Williams at an unrelated press conference whether that's true, he declined to answer.
And what happens then? Because we don't really know until that indictment is unsealed. We don't really know the scope of this and how big it really is.
And it could be.
Or not.
And that's right. It could just be the mayor. It could be others in his administration, including two top deputy mayors, the school's chancellor, the police commissioner, other police officials, his chief fundraiser. All of them have in some way become ensnared in this.
But there's no charges against them either. Will that happen? We don't know that.
We don't know. And look, the mayor says he is going to continue to lead, and he has things to run on and to lead with. He led the city out of the end of the pandemic. He oversaw a reduction in crime. He changed the way New Yorkers take out the trash. But this investigation has taken up a third of his tenure, and he has 1 year to go.
To be fair, he had more challenges than any other mayor ever in the history of New York, given that pandemic and everything else that was happening at the time.
It may be true, although federal prosecutors don't take that into consideration.
No question about it. Aaron, thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Bill.
Really good.
Now, only two New York City mayors have ever resigned from office. Jimmy Walker in 1932 and William O'Dwyer in 1950, both after corruption scandals. Of course, Mayor Adams has said he will not step down.
As we said, if he were to resign, as Jim Dolan mentioned, public advocate Jumaane Williams would become the acting mayor. Within 3 days, Williams would have to name a date for a special election to pick a new mayor.
And that special election would use ranked choice voting, where voters rank up to five candidates. Now, if a candidate gets more than 50% of first choice votes, they win. If not, the voting continues in rounds.
By the way, just in case you're wondering, New York Governor Hochul does have the power to remove the mayor from office, but a New York City mayor has never been removed by the governor. And again, no mayor has ever been charged while in office in New York City. Wow, so much to unpack. Mm. Aaron,